Hi, Jody.
I'm Tash.
So basically this is our second episode of two great mates, known each other for a long time, and it's just basically a download of our favourite things from beauty to books to... I'm bringing in a bit of booze because I own a pub now, but I was a model for many years. You're
makeup artist. And we're going to trial out some stuff today. What are we going to do? What are we doing today?
So I thought first we'll start with gin, because I thought it's always a good way to start, don't you think?
I think it'd be rude not to.
So this is a wonderful, wonderful wild Irish gin called Glendaclough.
Glendaclough. I love the label.
And it's basically being made by a really good friend of mine called Clodagh McKenna. And she has, I'll read the back because it's absolutely brilliant. So she's gone and she has found all of these kind of wild botanicals she's foraged. And they've literally taken all of these wonderful different ingredients that she's foraged, put them straight into the gin.
So she's foraged all the botanicals herself then done that.
So it says, Clodagh has chosen wild plants. They went straight to the still that day when they were picked. And the result is this incredibly spicy, beautiful gin, really beautiful of botanical oils. And so I thought we're going to try that because... I think, like our kind of key name, excuse the dogs and the kids.
Oh my God, the dogs and the children are driving us nuts.
Keeping it real. But what we like lazy luxury, don't we?
Yeah.
So you can either make this with a beautiful G&T or something like that, but I found these incredible brand and it's called Punchy.
I've got my glass ready.
I'm
ready.
Do you want these? So this is basically, they're like punches. So this is a soft punch. It's got no alcohol in it.
Brilliant. So if you don't drink alcohol or if you're off alcohol, you can just have those on their own.
Yeah. And I just love the
English?
Branding. Yes, they are. And they're basically very low calories. They're all natural ingredients. This is blood orange bitters and cardamom.
I love the old
branding,
school kind of branding. It's just super cool.
This is cucumber, yuzu, and rosemary.
Oh my God, can I try that one?
And I'm going to try the peach, ginger, and chai.
So they're 100, and also the cans are kind of like 100% recyclable.
Yep.
1% for the planet, so they give back.
Yep.
I really love a company, I think it's actually really important now, for a company to actually kind of giving back.
Totally.
I just don't.
And it's vegan, it's gluten free.
It's vegan, gluten free, low calorie, and it's also sparkling cucumber botanical, but obviously completely no alcohol. Yep. So if you're not drinking alcohol, and a lot of young people don't, you don't have to have
the
gin.
You've got to have a little tot.
I'm going to have the gin.
Have a little tot.
Thanks,
so,
baby.
I mean, you can do this a lot more kind of vibrant and put bits in.
But this is just, and also I love the feel of the label. I'm a bit of a feeler, toucher, feely girl, and I'd love
you?
Yeah, I am, baby.
I'm feely touchy.
I'm feeling punchy.
Are you feeling punchy?
Thank you.
Okay, so I'm going to try the peach, ginger, and chai, which I hope will work, but we'll give it a go. How's your cucumber? But I think, you know, that's that lazy luxury.
Yeah,
so
and you can just go bang, bang. And also it's a different point of view. It's not just shoving in a load of tonic.
But actually just drinking the gin on itself, you can taste those incredible...
Oh, it's lovely.
Wonderful botanics and everything. So it's such an amazing,
gorgeous
actually
paired with the gin, the cucumber, yuzu and rosemary is really perfect.
Ooh.
Did you really go a bit bananas?
Normally with a proper... gin thing, I think you need so much ice, which obviously it's hot and it's melted.
Cheers.
And it's not quite working, so we're just
so which one did you
it.
Go for
so I went for the peach ginger and chai,
which I think is quite punchy. I tried that initially.
Ginger works.
The ginger definitely works.
Definitely works.
But I think paired with gin, the cucumber and rosemary is just gorgeous,
and
because that's what you'd usually pair with gin.
It's quick. It's easy, you know, it's lovely to make a gin cocktail or something, and you can put all the wild bits that you want in, well, the wild bits you can put.
Yeah. You know, when they have put all the kind of the bullshit bravado.
which is what I call it.
What it's all about.
You know what I mean?
It's all about the
flair.
Now listen, I strive in the pub to do all the bullshit.
Do you? Yes. Do you like all that? It was like that kind of like...
But we're lazy.
I'm literally like, bang, bang, I'm happy. Thank you very much.
Mixing it with the punchy, I think, is really, really lovely. And also great if you don't want
to... Oh my God. And I'm also just, yeah, I mean, I can...
with them.
Super duper. Right.
Right.
Okay. So, next.
Next, we are going to talk about Skin and Tonic. So this is a beautiful brand. British, organic, sustainable brand that I've come across and am now involved in. So one of my favorite, I've got two favorite things here, which is the Calm Balm. We'll talk about that first, which is basically a product that I just keep on me and I just put it on to my pulse points.
Especially if you're slightly anxious, isn't it, with
exactly.
The Calm Balm.
Help it on you.
And so this is also, it's Soil Association Organic, and it doesn't, that they don't give those, they don't bandy those Soil Association.
Yeah, so you can put it on all your points. It smells absolutely beautiful. And in this kind of crazy world that we live in right now, oh, can you immediately
smell?
Oh my
God, you already feel like, okay,
so
with the Calm Balm, it literally is. So it's shea butter, lavender flower oil, Roman chamomile, sunflower, calendula, and rosemary.
Calendula. Yeah.
And rosemary. Oh my God.
Yeah. And that's
it's
it.
Just and you can you can, and also it's great if you've got dry elbows, dry kind of crusty heels.
Crusty bits.
That's nice.
Do you have lots of crusty bits?
I do not.
Do you?
I don't. I'm fairly buffed. In fact, I'll tell you about that another
time.
Okay.
Yeah.
But anyway,
that's another episode.
That's another episode. But then, it's just beautiful.
Yeah, and then they've got this rose mist, which has only got four ingredients, which is rose, flower, water, radish root, aloe, and a small amount of glycerine. And it basically is a beautiful fragrant mist that is made from soothing French rose, hydrating... That's the pug.
That's not my...
Boris!
Pug.
Boris, shh. Stop it. This beautiful fragrant mist is made from soothing French rose, hydrating cool aloe vera to calm and to tone the skin.
But so, how long does it last? I mean, with rose water, if it's very organic,
yeah.
I sometimes find it smells a bit like, you know...
No, this. Well, try. I've had this for 7 months.
But is there a shelf life with it? Because you can sometimes...
I'm sure everything has a shelf life.
Sometimes it can go a bit on the turn.
Well, what do you think?
It's beautiful. I like it. It smells lovely.
And it's still so rosy.
And it's still rosy and it doesn't smell... Yeah, I'll spritz you.
Boris! It's just something
that
I have... Oh, it's so just
and I like... Honestly, we could do a whole episode just on nozzles.
All right.
Sorry, but we won't.
That'd
but
be
actually,
very boring. Try not to do that.
It's
one.
Really boring, but I
is
swear.
Is it a good nozzle?
It's a good
is
nozzle.
Is it a good nozzle?
Because
okay.
I just want—I want the spray. I want it to go.
Rather than a
yeah,
your
like,
eye.
Like yeah. It's you know, and I'm sorry, people always skimp on that, and this
yeah.
is good.
It's beautiful. But basically, all of their products have got. So basically,
Teddy.
Bloody dog. So this is the Brit Beauty Oil, which is. Five ingredients.
And so what does that do?
So basically it's
the
serum.
Nighttime one?
It's a serum. It's rich in antioxidants, omegas 3 and 6. It's a delicate face serum, minimizes fine lines, reduces pore size, and encourages cellular function. Try out in the back of your hand. It's a really beautiful fresh oil.
Oh,
it doesn't
it's lovely. It doesn't even, it's not, what I love most about it is that it's not fragranced.
Yes.
I'm not a fragrance fan. People
no.
add fragrance because they get themselves into a right odd state and
yeah.
they just feel that they need to have loads of, and people just add fragrance.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's.
But the one thing I have to say about oil, when someone said to me, oh, you should use an oily serum, I was like, oh God, it's just going to block the pores,
yeah.
you're just going to have breakouts, and it was something that
really
kind of
nice,
terrified
actually.
Me.
Look, you can see the difference.
It does totally the opposite, you know, it kind of almost tightens the pores, it gets rid of those lines. It's a really beautiful, beautiful serum, and you can use it with, they've got a detox mask, and the thing I love about the mask, so you've got the detox one here, and then you've got the cocoa mask,
so it's thistle,
and it's a powder.
Chaya, borage, neroli, and vitamin E. Amazing.
So
oh,
it's
wow.
an actual powder, I don't know if you can see that.
Yeah.
And then you put a couple of drops of water into the powder and make it into a paste. And then that's your mask.
I love a powdered. I love a powder mask. I do. I mean, literally, I've got a couple of powdered masks. One from India, one from Marie Reynolds. And I literally, if someone's, and what it also should be filtered water as well.
Yeah.
It should be really kind of very, very, you know, because
clean
it's
just water.
Clean water.
Yeah.
But yeah.
So this is made with coconut milk, aloe vera, kaolin clay, hydrating facial mask that gently detoxifies, moisturizes dry skin, dry and thirsty skin, leaving it feeling really plump and dewy and ready for the long week ahead.
Brilliant.
That I've been using for years. I cannot live without it. It's absolutely gorgeous. So it's just a really beautiful.
And how many times a week would you use it then? Twice a week,
probably,
three times a week,
yes,
like
exactly.
Monday, Wednesday, Friday?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you know, if I've been doing a shoot or something and I've been using products that have been drying, or I've been, you know, doing something where I haven't been looking after myself,
and it kind of,
you know,
really,
traveling
and it,
or something and it, like that.
Yeah, okay.
It's something I'll use it, you know, one day and then the next day. That's one of the little things.
And put by in small batches by people, not machines.
Yes, yeah, so crafted
made
by...
in UK.
Yes.
And I like the UK. I want to big up the UK brand.
Exactly. And but the thing is, it's in actually how it works, and it works all of them so incredibly well. And it's just a brand that I totally love and adore. And it's kind of the way I want to go, which is really clean beauty.
Can I just say it's the only way, really, at the moment. As the lay of the land.
Do you want to know
that?
The lay of the land.
So yeah, it's the way it should go. It's the only way. You know, of course it should be cruelty free, and of course it should be organic.
Yeah.
Thank you, darling.
So it's a really special company that.
Brilliant.
Highly advised.
Yeah.